Yes, God has called us to win souls. God has called us, everyone, God has called you to win soul. You have to win somebody. You have to test, to give a testimony to your parents, to your brothers, to your family, to your community. Everyone of us has been called. You have no excuse. You have no excuse. Everyone has, God has called you. The Bible says God, men are chosen, men are called, but few are chosen. So you must be few who have been chosen. Now, I'm going to read from the book of Philippians 2, verse 10. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, I want to thank you this morning, God. I welcome you. I welcome your presence. I welcome the Holy Spirit, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and God was the Word. As God, you are the Word. I bring your Word to you, and you are the Word. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, let your presence fall upon us. Let your Holy Spirit fall upon us. Let your Word, that is you, God, my Father, manifest in our life in Jesus' name. My Father, this Word, God, let it reach to our beloved ones who have not known you, God, who have not saved. Lord, I pray that God, my Father, touch our family who have not saved, who do not know you, God, my Father. I pray that God, my God, those family, the people who have not known you, God, we pray that God reach, touch them, Lord. We are doing our part, and you are the only one who can bring them. You are the only one that who can save them, God. We have no power except you. God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, as your Word says, Lord, we will give to them, and we are praying and trust that, God, you will touch our beloved one. My Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We love you. We give all the glory. We give all the honor. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. I'm reading from the book of Philippians 2, verse 10 to 11. God has called us to win souls. God has called us to win souls. Philippians 2, verse 10 to 11. The Bible says that at the name of Jesus, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of those in heaven and those in earth. Every knee shall bow those in heaven and those in earth and those under the earth. At the every tongue, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Now, here is what the Bible says. Every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. You know, if there is any tongue that does not confess Jesus Christ as Savior, and Jesus himself says that they will not enter in the kingdom of heaven. Here, there is no condition. It is direct that every mouth, every tongue should confess Jesus Christ as Savior. Now, here, the Bible says that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow of those in heaven. Those in heaven, even those who are in heaven, they are bowing down. They are kneeling down to worship God. Those in heart, they are also kneeling down to worship God. And those who under the earth, there are some people who are in the heart, and there are some people who are under the earth. So all of them, they have to bow down and worship God. And every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. If there is anybody denying Jesus Christ that is not Lord, if there is any demon, any religious, any church, any religious, anybody that is denying that Jesus is not Lord, then the Bible says they cannot enter the kingdom of God. They cannot see. Because you cannot worship other gods. You can't deny Jesus. Then you say that you are worshiping God. They say every time. I pray that God Almighty every family, everyone in your family, everyone will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. If there is any deceiving spirit, it is the spirit that denying Jesus Christ is not Lord. Here is the scripture which says, Jesus Christ is Lord, King of kings, Lord of lords. Jesus Christ is everything, is the bridge. Jesus Christ is everything. Without Jesus, you cannot enter. Without Jesus, there is nothing you can do. You will pray through Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. That's why Jesus, we have to confess him. That's why we need to acknowledge him. Before Jesus, we are the Old Testament. The people were worshiping God direct, and they were having some, they have to sacrifice. They have to go through some stuff. But here, we don't do that anymore. We were given Jesus that we believe in him, and anything we ask in him, he will do it for us. Jesus, our Messiah, the King of kings and Lord of lords. Hallelujah. Yes, we thank God that God, Almighty King of glory, Jesus Christ. There are so many millions and millions, billions of people who have not received Jesus. We are praying, as I'm praying this, I'm planting a seed. And this seed, it will go. It will go all over the world. And if there is anybody who have not received Jesus as personal Savior, and Jesus is coming anytime, you have seen the in England, the in Europe, a pound as Christ. You have seen the economy of Britain is now shaken. You have seen the Prime Minister has resigned. You see, all this is the sign. This is the sign that Jesus Christ is coming. Jesus Christ is coming anytime. This is the last days. Now, what I'm telling you is the truth. Because the bond, the money, the dollars is losing their weight. Now they are going to decide to bring one currency. One currency will be, you cannot have any money except you have the mark 66. Soon 66 is going to announce from Europe. Whether you like it or not, they are going to declare one currency. The British people are very annoyed. They are not happy. They are not happy. So soon 66 is coming up because currency is losing their value. So they will say, we don't want to see sterling pound, we don't want to see dollars, we don't want to see euro, we don't want to see any money, we want to make one currency. And everyone will use this currency. Now, again, they are going to say, we don't want to see any money, we want everyone to have one currency and the mark, and that is a bank and everything. It is coming soon. British people, they are very upset. And the Europe people, they are very upset. They are going to say, enough is enough. We want to make one currency. And that is it. So if you have no Jesus Christ as personal Savior, and you die, you will go to hellfire. This is the clear word that God is talking to you. God is saying that he's calling you today to decide, if you are not saved, to receive him as Jesus Christ as personal. The Bible says every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. To the glory of God. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. We are the last days. You will hear soon. You will hear what is going to happen. They are going to declare right now. They are going to declare now we don't need this currency. It's bringing disaster to our country. One to one currency. And soon it's going to come. Hallelujah. Jesus is God. We thank him. Let's look at the verse of 1 Corinthians. First Corinthians 1:20-21. First Corinthians 1:20-21. The Bible says, where is the wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the dispute of this world? When the Bible says, where is the wise? It means, where is the wise person? Where is the wise person? Where is the teacher of the law? The scribes are the teachers of the law. Where is the prosophias of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of the world? God has made the foolish to the wisdom of the world. When I talk like this, people may think that I am a fool. I am a foolish because I'm talking salvation. And people have money. They are rich. They have everything. I remember one person, a white man. I was talking to him about Jesus. He looked at me and he said, "You need Jesus. I don't need Jesus. I have everything. I have money. I have everything." But the problem, this man was walking with a stick, walking stick. He was sick. He was so sick. But he has money and he was so sick. He had cancer. He has so many sickness. So now I said, "You are wealthy. You are well. But you have problem. You need Jesus to heal you. This sickness is only Jesus Christ can heal you. There is nobody can heal you. Cancer, Jesus Christ will merit it and you will be set free." We have seen cancer cases, people are being healed. We have seen high blood pressure, people being healed. So if you say that you don't need Jesus and he's the one who is a physician, is a doctor, why can't you receive Jesus Christ? Even if you die, you know where you are going. But if you die without Jesus, you will go to hellfire straight away, express to hellfire. So it may look foolish to the world, it may look stupid to the world, to the people, to other people. But the truth of it is that, for since in the wisdom of God, the world through its wisdom did not know him, God has pleased through the foolish of what we preach to save those who believe. So the world, for since in the wisdom of the world, through it is wisdom, the world with their wisdom, the world with their wisdom, the world with their wisdom, they don't know God. But God is good. He said, God is what was preached through the foolishness of what we preach. Although we preach like foolish, we preach like foolishness, we talk like foolish people, but the Bible says to it will save those who will believe. People will call you crazy. People will call you name, but it is going to save those who believe. Right now, those who will believe Jesus Christ will be saved. Hell is a bad place. You don't need hell. You don't need hell. Anyone to go to hell. Hell is where people are being tormented. People are going to cry there. Somebody went to hell and they saw how bad hell is. And now I pray that God will deliver you in the name of Jesus. Hell is not a good place that you will need your family to go there. Let me describe hell little bit about hell. There was two people. One was a rich and one was a poor man. The poor man, that's us. Those people who preach the gospel, and the rich people, they look at us and say that we don't know what we are doing. But we know Jesus Christ. Even if we die right now, we know where we go. And the rich man, he doesn't know God. He has everything, but he enjoys good. He has good house. He has money, car, everything. But he doesn't know one thing. He doesn't know God. He doesn't know Jesus Christ as his personal savior. Now, both of them died. The poor man, whom the rich man was giving food at the at like a dog. The food that the dogs eat, it was the one he was giving them. He was giving the poor man. Now, you know, the rich man, like, they see you like you are nothing. They treat you like rubbish. They don't, when you talk to Jesus, when you share with them to Jesus, they look at you, even they don't want to listen. They say, like, you don't have anything to do. They would ask, "You mean you can't look for a job to work? Is that what you can tell?" Now, it happened that this man died, and the poor man died. Now the poor man was received by the angels and he went straight to heaven where Abraham is. And then this rich man, the angels, the demons, the angels of Satan received him and sent him straight away to hellfire. Now in hellfire, he started suffer and being tormented there. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. When he was tormented, when he saw how pained and tormented he is, he looked up and he saw the man called Lazarus, the poor man, whom he was disrespecting, who was eating under his table where the food of the dogs are eating. He's sitting on the chest, on the brooms of Abraham, and Abraham was also there. The man said, "Is that not that poor man that I used to disrespect that I was treating so badly. Now, because he knows me, let me talk to him. Then he said, please help me. Please help me. I'm burning. My finger is burning. I'm in a bad place. Please help me. Then the man laughed at him and said, yes, you want me to help you now? But you had a chance. I was there sharing with you. But you didn't want to hear me, even to welcome me. You chased me. You were giving me the food dog. But God, and then this man said, please, even I need a little water, even the thumb of your water to cool my tongue, because the tongue was burning. The man was crying nonstop. The man was in pain. The man was suffering so much. Now, and then he said, there's no way we can help you here. You have every chance. You have every opportunity, but you abuse it. You didn't accept this. Now, the person you were disrespecting, you were treating so badly, is now here enjoying, and he is happy here. Now, this man said, okay, I can see that is Abraham. Father Abraham, please send people to go and tell my brothers not to come where I am. The Bible says, then, the Bible says that after this rich man begging Abraham to send people to from heaven to go and talk to his brother, Abraham told him, my friend, even if people comes from heaven to go there, those people cannot listen. There's preachers down there. There's people who are preaching, but they don't want to hear it. So let me come to them, because they have refused to obey the voice of God. There's preachers preaching there day and night. Radios is there, television, Periscope, every media, all these people, but they have decided not to obey, not to listen to the preachers. Now, because of that, they will go to hellfire. They have decided to take them to go themselves to hellfire. So hellfire is a place where people are tormented. God made the two people to see hell and to see heaven. Some people already have visited hell. I personally, God gave me a vision of hell and heaven. That's why I decided I will never backslide. I will fight and fight and fight to keep my salvation. I will fight and see my family are being saved. I will fight and see I see my children are being saved. That's why we fast. That's why I fast 3 days to seek God for the souls. Because I know how bad hell is. You don't need your family to go to hellfire. It's a painful place where people are being tormented. It is true that there is hell and there is heaven. Jesus is in heaven. The devil Satan has been built hellfire. And men who have gone there, they will suffer forever and ever. But in heaven, we will have eternal life. We will be happy and enjoying. I pray that God will deliver your people. Even if it looks like foolish to the world. But the truth is that God is there, and God has heard what I'm saying. And God, this voice, the message that I'm speaking, it will not go avoidly. It will go and accomplish what God has said. Therefore, even if you do whatever you are doing, you may think that I'm stupid, I'm foolish, but the truth of the matter, those who believed will be saved. Those people will believe my message, the message that I'm speaking will save. I am delivering this message to you, to your family, so that they can be saved. If something happened now, because anything can happen, we have seen disaster, we have seen a lot of earthquake. God can do anything, anytime, because of sins in the world. People have turned themselves to something else. People are worshiping idols. People have turned themselves to men. They have turned themselves to same sex. They have turned to self anything. They worship anything. God is not happy. God is not happy. I am calling you to tell you that if you are not saved, be saved. If you are going to church and you have not given your life to Jesus Christ, be saved. Even there are pastors, there are bishops, there are so many people who have not given their life to Jesus. There are pastors. I know people who go to church, they have not given their life to Jesus. I'm speaking to you right now, prophetically. If you have not given your life to Jesus, please decide to give your life to Jesus now. There is no time that you are waiting. God loves you and he has given you time up to now. Give your life to Jesus. If you die, something happened to you, you will go to hellfire and you will remember what I've said. I thank God that God will make you to remember what I have said. I'm telling you. Give your life to Jesus. Let's pray to our family, our neighbors, to be saved. Hallelujah. The Bible says in the book of Matthew 5, verse 1, 14 and 16, the Bible says, you are the salt of the earth. You are the salt of the earth. Ye are the light of the world. We are the salt of the earth. You know the salt? If the salt is entered in the water, it will taste, it will change. We are like that. Now, I am praying that God Almighty, let me be the salt of the world. And the Bible says, ye are the light of the world. We are the light of the world. We are the light of the world. Children of God, we are the light of the world. Now the devil knows that. And then it brings darkness. It cover you because we are the light of the world. Remember, you are the light of the world. A city that is set on an hill cannot be hid. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your God, glorifying the Father which is in heaven. You are the light of the world. The hill that cannot be hidden. You cannot hide yourself because you are the light. Where the light is, there's no way you can hide. Always where the light is, you can see. If there's a light, you can see there is a light. That's how you look like. Now, since you got yourself, you are shining. You are the light of the world. The Bible calls us, we are the light of the world. You see? But if you are not saved, you are the dark of the world. You are dark. You live in darkness. But we are saved, one. We are the light of the world. Therefore, because we are the light of the world, let our people, our family also become the light of the world. The Bible says, you can see, let your light so shine before men. Let your light, let your salvation shine before men. People are saved. They don't forget. People are saved. They don't kill. They don't steal. They don't do these things that people who are in the church do. They don't gossip. The Bible says that you may see your good works and glorifying your Father which is in heaven. We thank God. I thank God that God is able. I don't mind the children of the devil what they are writing. I know that they need salvation. I know that Jesus loves them. God loves them. Even if they, what they are writing, whatever they are commenting, if it's not glorying God, it is glorying their master, the devil, Lucifer, who is under feet. Therefore, I am not afraid of them, and I will not be moved what they are saying. Everything they are saying, the comment they are saying, it will go back to their heart and destroy them. If they cannot give their heart, if they cannot give their life to Jesus, they are finished. They are doomed. I thank God that God has made them to pass through my periscope. And they have heard what I'm saying, but they have decided not to listen. But now, the voice, they have heard me talking about salvation. They will not go free. Some of them, they will be my witness. They will be my witness. Some of them, if they do not obey, if they do not repent, if they do not give their life to Jesus, it will be too bad for them. I pray that God will deliver you in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that you've been praying for your son. Your son is saved. Your son has been saved. You have been praying for your family for a long time. This time, God has touched your family. All over the world, wherever is hearing my voice, wherever is hearing these videos, if you have been praying for your family, it is done. Rejoice and thank God. God has done them. You will be surprised what is going to happen to your family. They are saved. Even if they are not saying right now, in a few days, they will be saved. Something has planted inside their heart, and it is coming. It is germinating. It is coming, and they will confess with their own mouth. You remember what the Bible says? Every tongue will confess. So they are going to confess. I believe Jesus. I know that God has touched many, many men's soul. I am talking to church goers. People go to church. They don't know if they are saved. They are moved. They are everywhere. They are not sure. If you are not sure that you are saved or not, confess. Say, Lord Jesus, forgive me all my sins. Write my name in the book of the living. That's what it is. And start walking in the right way. Just confess, because you have to confess Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. Say, Lord Jesus. The Bible says that the word of God is in you, is in your mouth. If you confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, you will be saved. Romans 10:10. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. That you just confess. If you are not being born again, if you are not given your life to Jesus, confess, and that is it. Just open your mouth and say, Lord Jesus, forgive me, I am a sinner. Receive me, Lord. Write my name in the book of the living. Lord, my Father, forgive me all my sins. Then you are accepted. Your name will be written in the book of the living. And now you are become one, a citizen of heaven. You become a citizen of heaven. This, your citizenship is only to confess Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. Then you walk right way. You live the old life, then you come the new life. The Bible says, old has gone, new has come. Old has gone, new has come. Once you confess Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, everything has gone. All your sins is gone. New has come. So even if you were a criminal, you have done so bad stuff, abortus, you've been aborting so many children. When you confess Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, God is so merciful. He forgives you and forgets everything. God doesn't remember your sins. He forgets them. Therefore, people of God, don't remember your sins. God has forgiven you. You walk in the right way. Just walk in the right holiness. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be holiness. Remember holiness. Without holiness, you cannot also enter the kingdom of God. God needs holiness. You cannot live such a life, then you expect that the kingdom, you will enter the kingdom of God. The Bible says, many will say, Lord Jesus, we did miracles, we use your name, but Jesus will look at them and say, I don't know you, because you never walk in holiness. Therefore, make sure you live a holy life and keep the salvation that God has given to you. I pray that God would bless you. And those who are being saved, please live in a holy life. Holiness, upon Mount Zion, there shall be holiness. So therefore, holiness is needed. If you cannot live holy life, then heaven is not yours. People, they don't want to teach this. They better teach something else, prosperity. They better teach, yes, I love prophetic. Yes, prophetic is good to help people, and I want to prophesy as much as I can. But let us teach the people. People would like to go for prophecy, but they are living in a sin life. They are not saved. If they see a false prophet lying to them, they will run there to hear, but they are not saved. Where is it your prophecy will take you? Where is your prophecy will take you? You want to run for prophecy, but you have not given your life to Jesus. I am prophesying to you right now. If you have not given the life to Jesus, that is your prophetic. Deceive Jesus. Go to Jesus, confess Jesus Christ, and then other things will follow. Seek ye the kingdom of God, then other things will follow. Thank you very much. God bless you. God bless you so much. God bless you so much. I pray that God will save your people, God will deliver your people. Salvation has come to your house, and every one of you, everyone in your household will be saved in Jesus' name. Remember to go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. Call us, our number. If you need prayers, if you need me to read you to Jesus, if you need special prayers, counseling, I give free counseling. I am counseling people. I can give you 25 minutes, half an hour free counseling. I will prescribe you some prayers, prayer points that you need. It's like the doctor who prescribe you medication. So when you call me and I pray, I see your problem. Many people, I gave them prayers. I ask some to go to prayer and fasting. Some of them, I tell them to go and pray for 3 days, some 21 days, some even 7 days, some 5 days. It depends on the issues, your issues. So call me. I will pray with you. I will give you the prayer and prescribe prophecies to you if you need help. Call us. Our number is 905-487-7196. And we have a cell phone number. You can reach us 647-608-5207. You can WhatsApp, you can call us, you can text me. I will help you. I pray that God will deliver you, will deliver your children, will deliver your family in Jesus' name. Jesus Christ is forgiving us, and he will never remember your sins. Once he has forgiven you, he doesn't remember. God does not remember like you remember. When the enemy is reminding you, tell him, I have been forgiven. And don't remember your sins. It is God. That's why I'm praying that don't worry about what you have been doing. Many criminals who have given their life to Jesus, they are doing good. It is because they have given their life to Jesus. That's why they were able to stop what they were doing. Without Jesus, even if you take them to prison, they will say prison, prison, prison will be full. But still, they cannot accept Jesus Christ as personal. Who will stop Jesus Christ as personal? They will. Jesus will discipline them. They will help. Jesus will help them. And he will stop them addiction of any problem, any addiction. Anything, Jesus will change you, and you will turn yourself to become a different person. I thank you very much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isik, saying bye-bye to you. I will see you tomorrow, 8 o'clock. We don't have midnight prayer tonight. We don't have midnight prayer. We don't have midnight prayer today, tonight. And we don't have midnight tomorrow, Sunday. So, and Monday, three nights we don't have. Now the rest we have the night midnight prayers. We'll continue praying. So I thank God that God will help you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I pray for you that God will help you. I pray for the sick people. I was almost forgetting that. Holy Spirit, thank you. Yes, don't think that I was almost forgetting, but the Holy Spirit knows you. I pray for the sick person. People who have headache. You have been having a headache for the last, is it 3 weeks? Yes, almost 3 weeks. That headache, it has been worrying you. You don't know what to do. I pray that God will touch you. I command that demon, the spirit of death and hell that has entered in your head, I command them to vanish right now in the name of Jesus. You have been having some pains in your neck. Even you can't turn your neck. It is very stiff. I pray that you demon in that neck come out now. I curse you. I command you by the power and the blood of Jesus out in the name of Jesus Christ. Come out of that person right now in Jesus' name. I pray that God will touch your life in Jesus' name. I pray for you, Patricia. Every pains in your body to be melt. I command them to die in the name of Jesus. I am speaking to you right now. By the power that created the heaven and the earth, I am speaking every pain in your body, your chest, that is suffocating you, that make you can't breathe properly. I destroy them in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for the breathing. Some people, I see a man is having very difficulty breathing. The man is struggling. He doesn't breathe properly like other people. I command that demon in the chest to get out right now in the name of Jesus Christ. If you find yourself difficulty breathing, start breathing in and out. Start breathing in and out. If you want to throw it, start breathing. God has healing you. Yes, hallelujah. Yes, I see also these people, there are a couple of people with issues of stomach. They are very, they have problem. They have a lot of pain, abdomen. And yes, in their belly, their stomach. Right now, as I'm talking to you, you feel a lot of pain. The Holy Spirit is visiting you and it is melting every pain in your stomach. That pain that has been sleeping there, that has been attacking you, that has been very sharp pain. Even if you press it, you feel a lot of pain there. It is dead. It is destroyed in Jesus' name. Gallstone has been vanished in Jesus' name. Yes, Galveston, I am speaking to you right now. By the power and the blood of Jesus, I destroy you. I command you to get out in Jesus' name. Alisas, get out in the name of Jesus Christ. Out! I curse you in the name of Jesus. The person who injured your right hand, you were walking, then something make you to injured, you fall, then it twist your pain, your right hand. Right now, your right hand is on the chair because you can't walk, you can't step. In the name of Jesus, I pray that pain, that bone, that wherever it has twisted, it shall be vanished and destroyed in Jesus' name. The enemy wanted to break your bones and break you, but you twisted the feet. It has been paining you seriously. You lift it on the chair. You are putting one up and one down. Therefore, I cast out that demon to get out in Jesus' name. Start walking. Start walking and running in the house. You have been healed in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lord, I thank you. I thank you, Jesus. My God, I pray. I pray that the headache, the person with the headache has been healed in Jesus' name. I pray that God will deliver you today. As I know that God is not a liar to lie. Every word that comes out of the mouth, it will done what he has said. Therefore, people of God, I will see you tomorrow, 8 o'clock. We will have our Sunday service. Invite your family before you go to your church. Or we have that is a service, Sunday service. Therefore, I thank you for coming. God bless you so much. Have a wonderful morning, a wonderful time in your country. See you tomorrow. You are welcome to call me. And if you have anything you want to know, call me. I'm here to serve you. I am your pastor. God has called me. I am a lover. I love people. I love you so much. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you with the love of God. There's nothing I can do about it. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you very much. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye-bye. I love you to show you that I love you. Take care. Bye.